رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Welcome to Sawtul Quran English. We are doing Juz 26. We are doing short summary. We are going to cover Surah Al-Ahqaf and we are going to do up to Surah Al-Zariyah ayah number 30. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سورة الأحقاف حاميم تنزيل الكتاب من الله عزيز الحكيم. Here حاميم, the revelation of the book is from Allah the exalted in might excuse me and the wise. We did not create the heaven and earth, what is between them, except in truth, for a specified time. So everything there is a reason behind it, and so that we understand. But those who disbelieve from that of which they are warned are turning away. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, have you considered that which you invoke besides Allah? Show me what they have created of the earth, or do they have partnership in the creation of the heavens? Bring me a scripture revealed before this or remaining trace of knowledge if you should be truthful. But they won't be able to bring anything, you know, but they are just making up. Say, have you considered if the Quran was from Allah and you disbelieve in it while a witness from children of Israel has testified to something similar and believe, why you were arrogant? Indeed, Allah does not guide the wrongdoing people. This is in ayah number 10. And later we see those are the companions of paradise abiding eternally, their reward for what they used to do. رَبُّنَ اللَّهَ سُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. And they were firm on that. So we have to do istiqamat. So before that, what we are doing? They were innal ladina qalu rabbuna allaha summa istaqamu fala khawfun alaihim wala hum yahzanun. If you have firm belief, then only you can achieve this. Ayah number 14. Aisha radiallahu anha reported that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the best deeds to Allah are the incensed ones, even though they were few. No, do the continuous good deed, even it's very few, but don't stop it. Sometimes what happens, you know, you start very good halakha or something, because very few people are coming, you stop it. Keep it, istiqamat, firmness, do it for the sake of Allah, invite them. Like hurdles will come, no matter how many hurdles are coming, you know, inshallah, do it for the sake of Allah, Allah will help you. And have istiqamah. Istiqama is such a thing, you know. You should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again and again. You know, the person who has iman cannot be correct unless his heart is on the istiqama. You know, until he get that firmly, you know, have the istiqama. And وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَلَدِهِ إِحْسَانَ. And we have enjoined upon man to do good to his both parents. Do good. This is in ayah number 15. His mother carried him with hardship and gave birth to him. And gestation, weaning period is 30 months. You know how she has passed, you know, when the baby was there in the tummy. And after that, you know, weaning, like, you know, nursing to the children up to a certain age. Then he grows until when he reaches maturity. Reaches the age of 40 years, he says, my Lord, enable me to be grateful for your favor which you have bestowed upon me and upon my parents, and to work righteous, of which you will approve and make righteous for me my offsprings. Indeed, I have repented to you, and indeed I am of the Muslim. This is a beautiful dua in ayah number 15. And later we see in ayah number 17, but one who says to his parents, uff. What is uff is like, you know, kalima-e kariha, which is the filth which is attached to, you know, when you use the Q-tip to the ear, the filth attached to the Q-tip or the, you know, dirt underneath your nails, that will be. So that's the kalima kariha. So you hate that much. Why you want to say uff? Like, you know, it means you can't raise your voice in the front of your parents. So do you promise me that I will be brought forth from earth when generation before me have passed on oblivion while they call Allah for help? And to their son, woe to you, believe indeed the promise of Allah is truth. But he says, this is not but legends of the former people. You know, people, they reject because of arrogance and stubbornness. because of their forefathers, and they say, now they are saying fable tales. Because they don't want to believe it, and they are making up the things. And here, Vaskura Akha Ad and mentioned, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the brother of Ad, when he warned his people in the region of Ahqaf. So he warned, and warner had already passed on before him and after him, saying, do not worship except Allah. Indeed, I fear for you the punishment of a terrible day. And but still, even though warners came, they didn't believe it. And then why did those they took besides Allah as deities by which to approach him not aid them? Because other deities, they are falsehood. They are not going to help them. And they are astray, these people, because when they are asking other deities, they said, O our people, indeed we have heard a recited book revealed after Musa al-Islam. This is in ayah number 30, confirming what was before it, which the guiding truth and the straight path. People who don't want to believe, they don't. But who wants to believe, they are on the hidayah. So, fasbir kama sabrau ulul azmi minar rusul. In ayah number 35, consoling Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So be patient, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as were those of determination among the messengers, and do not be impatient for them. So now again and again, it will be on the day they see which they are promised, as though they had not remained in the world except for a day or so or an hour. This notification and any destroyer except the defiantly disobedient people, they are destroyed. And here we start Surah Al-Muhammad, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allazina kafaru wa saddu an sabilillahi adallu amaluhum. Those who disbelieve and avoid people from the way of Allah, He will waste their deeds. And in the next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Wallazina amanu wa amilu salihat. Those who believe and do righteous deeds, and believe what has been sent down to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and is truth from their Lord, and He will remove from their misdeeds and aim their condition. And in Sayyidihim wa yuslihu mbalahum, He will guide them and amend their condition and admit them to paradise He has made known to them. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, by Him in whose hands the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, everybody will recognize his dwellings in Jannah better than he recognize his dwelling in the world. You know, arrafaha lahum, you know, they will recognize as if they know their own home. How we go, you know, if we cover our eyes also, then also we can go. That's how it's going to be in the Jannah. Masalul jannati allati wu'idal muttaqun, and the description of paradise with the righteous are promised. What is the description? Allah says, wherein are rivers of water unaltered, rivers of milk, the taste of which never changes, river of wines delicious to those who drink, and rivers of purified honey in which they have from all kinds of fruits in Jannah, and forgiveness from their Lord like that of those who abide eternally in the fire, and given to drink scalding water that He will severely, intestines will be, you know, blister out and broken. This is in ayah number 15. You know, how the righteous will be honored, and those who are disbelievers, how they are. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, in Jannah there will be oceans of milk, water, honey and wine. From them rivers will gush out. So subhanallah, when we learn this, you know, we have that hasra to go to Jannah, and we all want to go to Jannah. May Allah give us tawfiq, and inshallah we should. Allahumma hasibni hisaban yaseer. Allah make our hisab very easy, so that we all can go to Jannah. Wallazina ihtadaw, and those who are guided, He increase them in guidance and give them their righteousness. So if you want hidayah, go on hidayah, Allah will increase in that. And here, وَيَخُولُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَوْلَا نُزِّلَتْ سُورَةٌ. In ayah number 20, those who believe say, why has a surah has not been sent down? But when a precious surah is revealed and fighting is mentioned, You see those in whose heart is hypocrisy look at you with the look of overcome by death. You know, actually they don't want to go, so they are like, oh, they have that fear of death. You know, they don't want to go. They think that if they go, they will die. And more appropriate for them would have been. So here, those who don't want to believe, just they are pretending and they are not. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ ارْتَدَوْا. Indeed, those who revert back to disbelief after guidance had become clear to them, Shaitan enticed them and prolonged hope for them. So may Allah save such kind of people from, you know, such kind of disbelief. And here, أَمْ حَسِبَ الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ. Or do those in whose heart is disease think that Allah would never expose their feelings, like, you know, hatred and all. Allah will expose that. This is in ayah number 29. And here, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. O you believe, obey Allah and Messenger and do not invalidate your deeds. So Prophet ﷺ said, he who innovate something in the matter of our meaning in Islam, this is not of it, it will be rejected by Allah. This is what it is called, bidah. And here, inna allatheena kafaru wa saddu sabeelillah, those people who disbelieve and stop other people from the way of Allah and then died while they were disbelievers, never will Allah forgive them. You know, this is the only life we have to ask forgiveness here only. Once they are dead in the disbelief, that's it. No forgiveness for them. And here in a later we learn in the ayah number 38, here you are those invited to spend in the cause of Allah, but among you are those who withhold out of greed. Out of greed and out of bukhal, and whoever withholds only withholds benefits from himself. You know, it's not gonna work. It and wallahu ghaniyun wa antum fuqara, and Allah is free of need. He's ghani. Well, you are needy, you are faqir, and Allah says, Allah don't need, we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you turn away, He will replace you with another people, then they will not be the likes of you. You know, we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here Allah is clearly saying in the last ayah, you know, He can replace us with the other people or like of it. Surah Al-Fath, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna fatna laka fathan mubeen. So here, indeed, we have given you Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam clear conquest, clear victory. The indication over here is to the Treaty of Hudaybiyah, which was apparently a defeat, since the Muslim has to agree on terms that were very unfavorable to them. But it was those very condition, those terms that through them Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened the gates for the success for the Muslim. And this is why the Treaty of Hudaybiyah is known as Fathul Mubin. And we learn that after several years in Medina and after the Battle of Khandaq, basically this is after Badr, this is after Uhud. This is after Khandaq, the Prophet ﷺ had a dream in which he saw that his companion and they were performing Umrah. And the dream of the Prophet always, it has to be true. So Prophet ﷺ instructed the Muslims to prepare for Umrah. And so 1400 Muslims went along with Rasulullah ﷺ to Makkah in order to perform Umrah. But what happened, you know, as the Mushrikeen learned of the Muslims approaching Makkah, they became very defensive. They did not want to allow Muslims to come into Mecca, because they had expelled the Muslims from Mecca in the first place and they had been fighting so many battles with them. So now they don't want, and you know, Mecca safely performed the Tawaf and Umrah. They don't want to. They want to interrupt these people who Mushrikeen. So what happened? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, he changed his route, more difficult road to make to Mecca. And this is why this is known as Hudaybiyah, because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ended up at Hudaybiyah. When Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam reached Hudaybiyah, the Mushrikeen had his army, small group of people, in the entrance of the Mecca with their weapons, making it very clear that the Muslims could not enter Mecca without a battle. Now, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he did not want to battle because of the course the Muslims were in the state of Ihram. You know how the condition will be in the Ihram. And we learned that the people volunteered, for the example, from Taif to the people from the neighboring tribe. They volunteered in order to convince to the people of Makkah to let the Muslims in, because this was not a good thing. But they didn't listen, and this goes on, and you know, then another clause, they were putting so many clause one after another, and so they were not allowed to do the Umrah. So everybody became so sad and so sad at this point. Umar radiallahu anhu, when he heard this ayat, when Allah revealed that you know, Fathul Mubin, this is not a victory, this is a victory, it's not a failure. So then they started, you know, telling each other. And it was not an easy thing though, but you know, Raditu Billahi Rabbam, whatever Allah has given, they have to agree on that. And that time it was really, they were in huzn, they were in the grief, but can't help it, you know, because they want to do Umrah that time. That Allah may forgive for you what proceeded of your sins and what follow, and complete His favors upon you, guide you a straight path. So here, because of they asking forgiveness, Allah will completely clean your records. And you know, because of this, they were upset and they were not even listening to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So they were asked to ask the forgiveness. And later on, in ayah number 4, we learn that, you know, He who sent down tranquility, calmness and peace into the hearts of the believers, because they have so much grief and upset because of that, Allah put the tranquility, sakinat, in their heart. And to Allah belongs the soldiers of the heavens and the earth, and ever is Allah knowing and wise. And here, later on we learn, you know, sometimes things look different, you know, it looks like win and lose condition. Sometimes even losing is winning forever. You have to remember that thing in your life. Don't think, oh, I'm going to lose it and I'll be a loser. No, don't think that. Have faith on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who remain behind of the Bedouins will say to you, oh, properties and our families occupied us, so ask forgiveness for us. And they say, their tongues, what is not within their hearts. They were saying the things which they don't mean about it. And later on we see in the ayah number 18, لَقَدْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, certainly was Allah pleased with the believers when they pledge allegiance to you, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, under the tree. He knew that what was in their hearts, so He sent down tranquility upon them and rewarded them with the eminent conquest. Here in ayah number 18, you see how this is mentioned again and again. Allah loved this act of believers, that how in that weak state when they were unprepared, they still came forward, they were tired, exhausted. Allah appreciate them, and much war booty which they take, and ever is Allah exalted and might and wise. And later here we learn, وَهُوَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَصَدُّكُمْ, and if the people, the one who disbelieve and they stop from the Masjidul Haram while the offering was prevented from reaching its place of sacrifice, and if not for believing men and women whom you did not know, that you might trample them and there would befall you because of them dishonor without your knowledge, you would have been permitted to enter Makkah. So in the fight, the Makkah, because there were still many Muslims whose Islam was unknown. So this was so that Almighty admits to His mercy whom He will. If He had been apart from them, He would have punished the disbelief among them with the painful punishment. And later we learn that in end of the ayahs, that it says Muhammad Rasulullah, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Messenger of Allah, and the name of Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is mentioned 3 times, and this is one of the places. And وَالَّذِينَ مَعُوا, and those with Him are forceful against the disbelievers, enemy merciful among themselves. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, the example of believers in regard to mutual love, affection and fellow feeling is that of one body. When any limb of it aches, the whole body aches. So we have to remember that we are one body. You see them bowing and prostrating in prayer, seek bounty from Allah and His pleasure. Their mark is on their faces from the trace of prostration because of sajda. This is their description in Torah, and the description in Gospel is a plant which produces its offshoots and strengthen them so they grow firm and stand upon their stacks, delighting the sowers, and so that Allah may enrage by them, the disbelievers. Allah has promised those who believe and do righteous deeds among them forgiveness and great reward. Here, Surah Al-Hujurat, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله واتقوا الله إن الله سميع عليم. O you have believed, do not put yourself before Allah and His Messenger. Means don't try to get ahead of Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Do not put your own statement before the statement of Allah and Rasul. When the command of Allah comes, then put your will, your wish, your feelings after that, not before. And when the command of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam comes, first Allah, then the command of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Don't think about yourself. Samena vatana. And here, ya ayyuhallazina amanu tarju aswatakum, you know, you who have believed, do not raise your voice above the voice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We are not supposed to raise our voice. Means now Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not alive. How we used to do, like, you know, when hadith is going on, when we are talking about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we are not supposed to raise our voice. And also here we learn an incident, you know, two companions, they were raising their voice and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was there. This is like disrespecting him. And later on, those Sahabas, they were so calm and they were talking as if they are whispering. So we should respect Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in that manner. Indeed, those who call you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from behind the chambers, most of them do not use reason. You know, you can't go and call them. You know, people who are Bedouins, they used to call so loudly to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They were opposed not to do that way. If they had been patient until you could come out to them, it would have been better. You know, they should have patience until Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is coming out. Again in ayah number 6, Ya ayyuhallazina aman, O you have believed, if there comes to you a disobedient one with information, investigate. You know, somebody is bringing some news, just investigate. You know, lest you harm a people out of ignorance and become over what you have done regretful. So you make sure, like, whether it's correct or not. And know that among you is Messenger of Allah. If we were to obey you in much of the matter, you would be in difficulty. But Allah has endured to you faith and has made pleasing in your hearts. And later, this is very beautiful surah. Innamal mu'minuna ikhwa. The believers are but brothers. So make settlements between your brothers and fear Allah that you may receive mercy. You know, if some two people have some conflict, don't put more conflicts in that. Make amend the relationship and make them meet each other, you know. And here, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, again, who you believe, let not a people ridicule another people. Perhaps they may be better. You know, people are mocking in front of them and also in back of them. Allah is saying, you know, maybe they are better than you when you are ridiculing them. You don't know how they are. And, you know, don't do negative assumptions, you know, in ayah number 12. Because assumptions are sinful act, you know. If you see somebody, oh, she must be having boyfriend, she must be having... No, don't do a negative assumption. Ya ayyuhannas, O mankind, indeed we have created you from male and female and made it many peoples and tribes and so on. And Bedouins say, we believe, you have not yet believed. They say, but they actually didn't believe. And here in ayah number 16, say, would you acquaint Allah with your religion? By Allah knows what is in heaven and earth. Allah is knowing of all the things. And here, indeed Allah knows unseen aspects of the heaven and earth. Allah is seeing and know what you do. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.